For those of you that can't get away on vacation to get a taste of the tropics, well, we're bringing the taste of tropics to you. We are about to explore one of the hottest Mexican restaurants in Vancouver, Las Margaritas. Be my guest as we experience the culture of Mexican food.
Well, I grew up, in, of course, in a Mexican family. My grandmother, my mother cooking daily, making tortillas. And I'd come home from school and watch her cook and enjoyed the food, obviously. And then I got into the restaurant business, washing dishes when I was a kid going to school. And it just went from there. And I just wanted to open a Mexican restaurant.
So now coming into Las Margaritas, what type of ambiance and style does it have?
Well, what I created here is, I call it border Mexican cantina. So it's a little bit rough and readier, I call it. But it's a cantina atmosphere. You'll see a lot of photos, a lot of color, bright colors. The bar is prominent as well in the drinks that we serve here. So it's more cantina style.
Now, typically when you go to Mexico and different parts of Mexico, they serve different types of Mexican food.
That's right.
So what type of food do you serve here at Las Margaritas?
Well, a little bit of everything. We will do some from the coast, out of the Baja, of course, because we're on the border. I come from California. We also do some from the Yucatan. We have a dish that we prepare here, a few dishes, seafood, and some from Central. So it's a mixture, a little bit of all, of everything, but I would say it's closer to border Mexican food.
So I'm very excited that I'm in the kitchen of Las Margaritas, and I'm speaking with Chef Menendez. Hello.
Hi.
So tell me, what dishes do you typically serve here at Las Margaritas?
Oh, the typical dish we serve here is the fajitas. And with that, like, we have chicken fajitas and beef fajitas, prawn fajitas, and also the vegetarian fajitas for the people who doesn't eat meat.
That sounds amazing. So does the platter come out sizzling to the table?
Yes, that's right.
Excellent. So what are you preparing right now?
I'm going to prepare cochinita pibil.
Okay.
If you don't mind, could you help me?
Absolutely.
Could you chop a little bit of the parsley?
Oh, sure. Love to. So what is it that you have on the plate there right now?
We have here a banana leaf. Like, we use it right now for decoration.
Right.
Also, we use it to cook the cochinita, the meat.
Okay.
When we bake it, we rub in that, and they get a really nice flavor. And the plate is coming with a black beans.
Now, do you prepare the black beans at all, or?
Yeah. Everything here, yeah.
Okay, and everything is made fresh here as well,
yeah.
From what I'm told. Everything from scratch.
Yes.
That's amazing, yes. Okay.
And also, it's coming with the traditional Mexican rice, making with tomatoes, garlic, onion, and everything.
Right.
So for that is the color of the rice. And it's garnished with a...
Okay, I'll bring my parsley with me.
It's garnished with onions and jalapeno pepper, marinated with lemon lime juice.
Right.
For 24 hours and after that.
So that's quite nice. Like, look at the color of that. That really brings out the dish.
Onions, yeah.
So it's
very
really nice.
Really nice.
Okay.
And we finish the plate with the feta cheese on the black beans.
Now, what is the purpose of having feta on the black beans?
For the flavor, and because the feta cheese is a little salty, and this, the combination between the black bean and feta, really good.
Right. Okay. And I guess I need is a finishing touch of my chopped parsley.
Go ahead.
I guess I put it right there?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, wonderful. And what's this dish called?
It's cochinita pibil.
So this is the cochinita pibil. Looks absolutely fantastic. I can't wait to sink my teeth into it.
Yeah.
Hello.
Well, I'm starting to feel the mood of the Mexican fiesta, but there's still something missing. Mexican cocktails. What would you suggest that I would drink with my plated food here?
Well, you can't go wrong with a margarita. This right here is a classic margarita, which is tequila, orange liqueur, and lemon lime juice shaken on the rocks.
I'm not too sure if I'm really in the mood for that, actually. I'm kind of in the mood for a Mexican beer. What do you got?
Well, the best way to drink a beer on a hot Mexican day is to make it into a michelada.
A michelada. This sounds interesting.
Yes, well, the ice and the fresh squeezed lemon lime juice, you just pour the beer in there. And in some parts of Mexico, they add Tabasco or Worcester, and it's very refreshing.
It's like a beer, Mexican beer with a twist.
That's right.
But there is one thing that I'm dying to talk to you about, and that is Mexican tequila.
Well, there are lots and lots of tequilas out there. There's three types of tequilas. There's silvers, reposados, and añejos. And these are two of our best here. This is the Herradura Reposado. And then this is the Don Julio 1942. It's an añejo. Now, you'd want to drink a silver before your meal, because it actually increases your appetite. And for after the meal, have a nice añejo, and it settles the stomach.
Excellent. You know what? I think I'm going to go for the michelada.
Done.
Thank you.
Salud.
Well, now I know where to go when I get the itch for Mexico. You could stop by Las Margaritas at 1999 West 4th in Vancouver, or you can also check them out online. I'm Linda Stang, talking food for Talk Travel TV. I'm going to get back to my conchinita. Adios, amigos.